Hi, this is Jason Kang. Today we're going to try to clone the header, especially the left part of the header right here. Today we're going to do some demo so that we can see how everything we talked about come to work together. So if you could, please open your laptop and follow along. Now they understand some basic concepts of frontend and backend, let's start writing some codes to see how they come to work together. I thought it'd be good for us to create our own blog to represent ourselves. But if we were to build our project from the bottom, it'd take a lot of work. So I thought it'd be best to clone the existing projects. Cloning a website means to make it look exactly like the original. It helps you understand the HTML structure and how to apply styles to them. I chose Medium as our platform because it's very simple and straightforward. Hopefully you'll get some ideas about how to apply styles to HTML elements, how JavaScript works along with HTML and CSS, and how the server interacts with the client. This is a Medium blog that I created. And today we're going to try to clone the header, especially the left part of the header right here. So if you see, there are three links. This one links to the profile. This one to a list of the posts that I subscribe to. This one is about personal information. First, let's create the header as a parent element and add three link elements as children. Like that. And then let's add some class names to it to apply styles. Like that. Now let's go back to the Medium block and look at the console to get the styles. Let's get the color. And then the colors of the other elements too. There we go. See the color change here, right? And then let's get the height of the header. Where is it? So it's the minimum height is 115 pixels. Then let's add some background color to see the exact area it takes up. And here you can see there's space between the header and the body. That is because there's default margin. So let's get rid of it. There we go. And if you remember from the flexbox, we can use the flexbox to style the children elements. So I'm going to set display as flex. Flex direction as row. Is align items to make them align at the center. Here, and let's get rid of the background color. Let's space them out and change the font sizes. If you look, there is a margin of 48 pixels, but I'm going to use paddings instead to style them. So it moves inwardly. And then get the fonts. See font size, font weight, and line height here. Line height determines the size of the element box. When font size determines the font size, the line height allows you to change the spacing between each line. you see it got bigger. Let's go to the smaller ones too. It says inherit, which means it's gonna take the styles from its parent element. So let's go to the parent to check the styles. They are right here. Like that. And let's space them up. See the margin 12 pixels on the small links. Now they are fall apart. Oops. Never mind, two small ones. And then the bigger one should have a margin too. So it's margin right, 24 pixels. And that's it. All the styles are applied together, but you can tell that they don't look exactly the same. That's because the fonts are different. So in a later session, let's talk about how to apply different fonts to your projects. This demo is going to be in a series, so make sure you watch all the videos so we can complete this project together. And as always, if you want to learn something specific, please leave them in the comments below so I can answer your questions. Thank you, and stay tuned.